mother somewhere, alone and frightened. Oh, the darkness, the days are long.
Renowned Pan-Africanist Professor Patrick Loch Otieno Lumumba was the keynote speaker at the closing of a three-day national HIV/AIDS symposium at Makerere Business School in Kampala. In his remarks on domestic financing for HIV/AIDS response, Lumumba challenged African countries, Uganda inclusive, to stop dependence on donors for HIV/AIDS response by making deliberate investments in the health sector. He says there is a need to have a local funding strategy in Uganda, East Africa, and at the continental level so as to reduce donor dependence.
Very little money is dedicated to our health departments, with the consequence that in areas such as HIV/AIDS, if you go to almost all African countries, the support we have is heavily skewed, and it is through donor support. I'm told here in Uganda, over 80% of your budget is covered by donors, and other African countries not shy of the 80%. And I can tell you that if it is supported in that manner, it cannot be sustained.
Lumumba says it is high time the Ugandan government activates the HIV/AIDS Trust Fund to end reliance on dwindling funds from development partners.
I'm informed that in Uganda, your parliament in its wisdom made a decision to create a HIV/AIDS Trust Fund. That was several years ago. Africa is never short of good intentions. Africa is never short of good laws. In fact, in Africa, there is a forest of good laws which are honored in breach. So one of the areas in which you could begin talking about populating that fund with money is to activate that fund.
He condemned political leaders who have made it a practice to swindle donor funds dedicated towards the fight against HIV/AIDS. He adds that until Africans unite to end HIV/AIDS, the virus will continue devouring millions of Africans.
Got to look at domestic resources. I hope that one of the outcomes of this engagement is that the Uganda AIDS Commission will put together a working party of not more than three. Africans are in the business of appointing commissions of 50 people who never want to finish because of allowances. A working party of not more than three individuals with a set time limit, whose only agenda is to ask how are we going to liberate ourselves from donor funding.
Other speakers also expressed mixed reactions on the funding gaps in the HIV/AIDS prevention and control.
Progressively moved towards reducing dependency on donor funding for the health sector. Between 2018-19 and to date, funding for HIV/AIDS from government coffers has more than doubled, increasing from 97 billion to 197 billion.
On behalf of the persons living with HIV/AIDS, Flavia Chomukama, the executive director of Action Group for Health Rights and HIV/AIDS, urged government to ensure economic empowerment for people living with HIV/AIDS.
I'd like to implore government to engage us and also donors that we do budget tracking and monitoring and ensure that we support government. It's not like we are fighting or trying to look for fault, but support our partners and work as a team to ensure that the money that comes in is real value for money and improves the lives of communities.
Uganda's HIV funding deficit stands at 450 billion shillings, according to the Uganda AIDS Commission. The stakeholders are calling for enhanced funding. Rachel Nachuala reporting for the news.